Hi there, this is Vadim Michalenka, and in this quick video, we're going to look at the most typical Excel interview questions. We're going to start by looking at VLOOKUP Formula. We'll look at the differences between desktop version of Excel and Office 365. We'll also look at the different functions and formulas. What are they? How are they used? What is the sequence of evaluating formulas in Excel? And a lot more. So stay here with me on this channel. Let's start by looking at VLOOKUP Formula, because this is one of the most frequently asked Excel interview questions.
Let's start with the quick example. In this example, we need to find order amount based on the known order ID, and we have a table of existing orders. To do this, we will type equals VLOOKUP and then provide four values. First value is the known value that we're searching for. In our case, this is cell A7. With the order ID number 839293. Second value is the range in which we will be searching. Third value is the column index for the column that we need. And in our case, this is column D, which contains amount. But numerically, this is column number 4, because order ID is column number 1, name is column number 2, email is 3, and then amount is column number 4. And then we'll provide the last value, false, for exact match. Once we finalize the formula, you see that the value found is $423.38. And as you can see, this is the amount for the order 839293. The VLOOKUP function in Excel performs a vertical lookup by searching for a value in the first column of the table and returning the value in the same row based on the index number position. For example, if your table contains list of orders, you can find customer name, email, amount, ship date, or other available attributes of the order based on a known order ID. For example, if your order ID is 839287, you can run lookup to find customer name, which would be Ivana Weber, or email, which would be ivanaweber@tridenta.com, or find the order amount in the amount of $406.92, which was shipped on September 7th, 2018. To add VLOOKUP function, you need to navigate to Formulas tab and then click on an Insert Function button. Then you type VLOOKUP and find the formula. There are four values we need to provide. Lookup value is the known value we will be searching for. Table array is the area which we'll be searching. Lookup index number is the index of the column which will be returned that contains the value we're looking for. And then range specifies the way we will be searching. False indicates exact match, and true would be not exact match. We will be using false. Let's add VLOOKUP formula using this functions arguments dialog box. For the lookup value, we'll provide A7. For table array, we'll select the range between A2 and E51. For the column index number, since we're looking for amount, we'll select 4. And for range lookup, we'll select false for exact match. And you can see that we've selected order 839293, and the amount for this order is $423.38.
Now, let's look at how to use VLOOKUP formula to find other attributes of the order.
VLOOKUP formula in Microsoft Excel helps you find specific value based on the one known value. For example, we're looking at the list of orders in this table. We have order ID, name, email, amount, and ship date. And our business case is we need to find customer email based on a specific order number, or we need to find order amount based on a specific order number. Using VLOOKUP formula, we can supply order ID and find any of the remaining attributes here listed here in this table. This is the syntax of VLOOKUP formula. You need to supply known value, in our case it would be order ID, then you need to supply range for searching, and you need to identify that. Then you need to specify the column we are searching for, because different column represents different value. And then you need to define the match type. How exactly are you gonna match the value? Now, as we know the syntax, let's use VLOOKUP formula to find email address of the customer for the order 839284. To do that, I'm gonna type VLOOKUP, then the order ID 839284. Then I need to identify the range of the cells where I will be searching for the information, and the range is between the cells of A2 to E23. Then I would need to specify the email column in this range, and the email column is number 3, because the first one is order ID, second one is the name, and the third one is the email. And then I need to specify the type of match. True is an approximate match and false is the exact match. So I'm gonna use false for exact match.
If you're interested to learn more about Microsoft Excel, I recommend training course on Udemy. Just navigate to howtoanalyzedata.net/excel to learn more. I've carefully selected this course and you get substantial discount from the retail price. Just to let you know, this is an affiliate link and I get small commission if you make the order. Don't make purchases though if you don't need it, but thank you for your consideration and support of this channel.
Based on the information I provided, system found email for Catherine Moffitt. Let's look at how VLOOKUP can help us solve specific business problems. For example, how can you find customer name or email based on specific order number? Or how can you find order amount based on order number? Or how can you find ship date? First, let's look at name and email. VLOOKUP can only return one value, so we would need to do name first and then email. As I started typing, please pay attention that instead of putting specific order number, I put in the cell reference, which is A6 in this case. And we'll see how this will impact copying and pasting of VLOOKUP formula in solving later business problems. We supplied order number by putting the reference to A6 cell, then we specified the range, and then we specify the column ID for where the information should be taken from. And the last step is we specify how we're gonna match the data. We picked an exact match by supplying the value false, and the name of Aliyah Reeve has been returned by VLOOKUP, which is the exact correct value. Question number 5. What is the difference between Microsoft Excel for the desktop and Excel in Office 365? Office 2016 for desktop is the newest version of Office Productivity Suite, which includes Excel, Word, PowerPoint, and other Office applications, which are typically accessed via the desktop. Office 365, on the other hand, is the cloud-based subscription to a suite of programs including Office 2016. Office files can be accessed in the browser and on mobile devices, which allows businesses and individuals for more flexibility. You can also download and install Office 2016, including Excel 2016, on your desktop as part of Office 365 subscription. Full desktop version of Office, which includes Word, PowerPoint, Excel, OneNote, and Publisher, is included with license for up to 5 computers per user. Another big difference is in pricing. Office 2016 is the standalone version with the one-time cost per user, so you just make your purchase once. You pay a large amount of money upfront, but you don't have to pay a monthly fee after. Office 365, on the other hand, is the subscription plan, meaning that you won't pay anything upfront, but you pay a set of monthly fees per user per month. And if you don't want to spend a lot of money upfront, paying monthly might be a better option for you, because you can cancel at any time also.
Question number 4. What are the most useful functions in Microsoft Excel?
One of the most useful Excel functions is Sum, which allows you to quickly sum a range of cells by using Auto Sum button. It automatically enters the sum functions in the selected cells. The sum function totals one or more numbers in the range of cells. Other useful functions are Average, Max, and Min. Average calculates average value from the range of cells. Max calculates the maximum value, and Min calculates the minimum value in the range of cells. Excel has a lot of functions available to you, and based on the work that you're doing, you will be selecting and favoring some of the specific functions based on the job. You also will be able to write your own functions and calculate some specific values based on the work that you need to accomplish.
Question number 3. What is the function in Microsoft Excel?
Functions are predefined formulas that allow you to do calculations, and they are already available in Excel. Formulas and functions in Excel are useful to perform various mathematical, statistical, and logical operations. You can type in formula, though you have to be sure it's exactly right, or you can use Excel's preset formulas called functions. If you type in formula, you must start with an equal sign, so Excel knows that the data in the cell is a formula. After the equal sign, what comes next depends on what you're trying to do. Excel offers you some suggestions and shows syntax for a given function. Excel also corrects you and provides suggestions if you've made a mistake while typing.
Question number 2. What is the sequence of operations being executed when formulas are executed in Microsoft Excel?
Excel uses specific order when it evaluates operations in formulas. First, it goes and looks at the parentheses, then it looks at exponents, multiplication, division, addition, and then subtraction. You might recognize the term PEMDAS, P-E-M-D-A-S, and that stands exactly for what we just described. When evaluating formula, Excel always processes operations in this order. If you find yourself receiving an unexpected result from the mathematical operation, double check to make sure that parentheses are used properly to achieve the results that you want.
And question number 1, what is the most important data types used in Microsoft Excel?
There are 4 important data types in Microsoft Excel, and they are numbers, dates, percentages, and strings. Numbers are one of the most frequently used data types in Excel. They can be formatted with specific number of decimal places, and they can appear with or without commas separating the 1,000 digits. Numbers can also be added, subtracted, divided, multiplied, or included in formulas and functions that accept numerical inputs. Dates represent specific date and time. Dates are sorted differently than numbers because they represent different values. Percentages are very special numbers that multiply a given number by 100 and add percentage sign in the end. And strings represent free-form text, and they are stored as text, could be letters, numbers, and punctuation signs, and also could be stored in your cells. Excel needs to be able to differentiate between those key data types because it needs to know how to sort the data and how to do calculations. And they are all done differently for those different data types.
Have you enjoyed this episode? Make sure to subscribe so you will not miss the next one. And tell your friends about it. You can find links and downloads in the description section of this video. There are a lot of helpful links and a lot of other helpful information you will benefit from.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.